Welcome to Talkathon. This is the platform to connect the virtual space with the physical world. Today we have two big personalities with us, along with them the IFFI director Shankar Mohan. Mr. Govind Nihalani is the film director, cinematographer, screenwriter and producer. He is known for his Hindi cinema. Mr. Mike Pandey is an iconic wildlife conservationist and environmentalist, a big filmmaker, and here in Indian panorama, he is a chairman of jury of a non-feature category. And along with me is the co-host Rahul Agarwal.
So, हमेशा की तरह हम शुरू करते हैं ये सवाल-जवाब का ये छोटा सा सिलसिला हमारी एक कोशिश है कि साइबर स्पेस के जितने दर्शक हैं जो कि इफी को लगातार फॉलो कर रहे हैं और वो ये इस वर्ष यहाँ पर नहीं आ पाए हैं वो अपने सवाल सीधे डायरेक्टर प्रोड्यूसर्स और साथ ही इफी डायरेक्टर से पूछ सकते हैं तो शुरू करते हैं आज का सवालों का यह सिलसिला सबसे पहला सवाल माइक पांडे जी आपके लिए आया हुआ है माइक विच इज द बेस्ट डॉक्यूमेंट्री विच यू हैव प्रोड्यूस्ड सो फार
आई थिंक ऑल द डॉक्यूमेंट्रीज आर जस्ट वन बेटर देन द अदर बट Most importantly, I think the ones that made a significant difference and actually were effective in saving a species from extinction was the whale shark film. And it brought conservation not only in India. For the first time, a law was enacted to protect a marine species. Till then, there was no law to protect any marine species. And 6 months later, it was a catalyst and it brought global conservation for the whale shark. Before that, the whale shark was not protected. So I think what the United Nations said that it is the most powerful conservation film in the world is a great honor for us in India and for me to be able to be there at the right time to be able to film this to bring it in effect. And I think this is one of the most powerful documentaries in the world today.
I think, sir, it won the Green Oscar Award as well, sir?
Yeah, it won the Green Oscar and it won the Son of the Earth Award, the Prithvi Ratna Award and the UN Award. For outstanding conservation, and I think there were about 20-30 awards it won all over the world, and it's still being used as a tool for conservation, as a training film, and how one film can be so effective to bring about change.
Great. Now, Govindji, there is one question for you. Govindji, when can we see another film with Big B?
Well, very soon. I think early next year.
Great.
It's a full-length feature film in animation called Kamlu, Happy Happy. And, well, the trailer is on the YouTube. But this is a film about a baby camel and who wants to fly. So, why he wants to fly? Why he wants to fly, whether he fly or not, and what happens when he flies?
शंकर जी आपके लिए क्वेश्चन आया है कि क्वेश्चन ये था कि शंकर जी वी वांट यू टू ऑर्गेनाइज वर्चुअल क्लासेस विद दिस फिल्म लेजेंड तो टॉकथन शुरू है
आई थिंक इट्स अ ब्रिलियंट आइडिया बिकॉज नाउ दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड टॉकथन एंड दिस वुड बी वन वे ऑफ क्रिएटिंग फिल्म अवेयरनेस विद रिगार्ड टू सिनेमा with regard to what constitutes good cinema and what exactly good cinema means in terms of its outreach to several people. So I think this is a brilliant idea and we should explore that also.
There is one question. Mike sahab, aapke liye, many people think that good film schools were only for rich kids. What is your take on it?
I think it is not true because somebody can be very rich, but he may not have the knack or the tact of telling a story. Good films are about telling stories. Good stories, how to tell stories effectively. And that's what's most important, you see.
Okay.
And it's not the domain of the rich alone. It's the domain of the imaginative, of the one who has got the flexibility of mind. Anybody, I think every single person is a storyteller. How well you tell the story determines how good a filmmaker you are.
But I think he was asking about the film training institutes.
I think there are some training institutes that are expensive and out of reach. But if you make a starting, if you start even with a cell phone or a small camera and you can put together pictures, you will be visible. And today, there are so many festivals happening. Look at the organization that I'm at the moment chairing, IDPA, Indian Documentary Producers Association. Our mandate is a public trust. We encourage young people who want to make films, please send your films to us. We'll look at it, and if we see you have the knack or the flair, we'll do our best to help you and take you where you must go.
This is very kind of IDPA.
Encouragement की बात हो रही थी और एक सवाल आ गया आपके लिए. वो पूछना चाह रहे हैं कि if you had to sum up your advice in a few words to students and amateur filmmakers, what it would be?
You see, there's no comparison to a structured education in any craft. So I would say the first preference should be to learn the craft filmmaking through a structured course in a good institute. Of course, they're expensive, but every film school is not all that expensive. One can always find a way. The other way is to struggle and learn on your own, becoming somebody's assistant. It's time consuming. And then you learn only that much, but if you take a course, then your horizons expand even more. You study more styles, you are exposed to much more knowledge, analysis, and all that. So I think structured training is very important.
Just to add on to that, you know, I fully agree with what Govindji is saying, because I am also from a film school. Structured training always helps. And today you have several film schools, you know, which are sponsored by government. You have it in Chennai, you have it in Bangalore, you have it in Calcutta, you have it in Pune, in Delhi. All the metro cities have. So I think to initiate yourself, you should go in for any one of these, you know, which are, but the structured training is required. Otherwise, you'll have to go through the struggle, as Govindji was saying, and it takes time. But always you can start with self-study. There are several books available on filmmaking. You know, so start reading. Mary Seaton has written several books on the art of filmmaking. So just walk into a library or walk into a bookstall. You know, if you're keen and passionate about making films, get a good book, read about it, and then start your journey from there on.
One more question is coming for you, sir. Since I think this must be coming from the delegate side, I suppose, because she is just asking that there are only 3 days left for this IFFI, and how is your feeling, and what are the end work that is supposed to be done?
Very nostalgic, at the same time greatly relieved.
Okay, why greatly relieved, sir?
You must realize that it's a huge festival. You know, the magnitude of this festival is 11-day mega festival, and you have nearly 13,500 delegates. And you have these 11 days rolling, and you need to, you know, just ensure that nothing goes wrong. In spite of that, several things do go wrong, but you just ensure that, you know, whatever wrong happens, you correct it. So it's not an easy task running the festival, but I have a team of people, I have a lot of support, help and support, and I have a lot of goodwill, which helps me, you know, sail through the festival. So in that sense, it's a relief also for me. And yet nostalgic.
I'm sure he must be planning a one day's beer and beach.
बिल्कुल beer and beach गोवा है. तो माइक पांडे जी, एक सवाल अभी भी आया है बिल्कुल, और मुझको लगता है कि इसका जवाब बेहतर दे पाएंगे. रशीदा है शायद इंटरनेशनल कोई ट्विटर है जिन्होंने अभी हमको ट्वीट किया है, जानना चाहती है कि डॉक्यूमेंट्रीज कैन बी स्क्रिप्टेड और मेड ऑन द एडिटिंग टेबल. What, according to you, is the best format?
Is it through scripting or through editing?
Yeah.
Mike.
The question is whether you're talking about scripts or editing. And if you look at the current formats are changing nearly every day. Right now, we are working with 16:9, then we're going into 4Ks and 6Ks. Scripts are something that develop. Your first draft may not be your best. You keep on working till you go through multiple drafts and redrafts till you come to what you think almost works. And I think a good filmmaker is, even by the time he finishes, he's still not very happy. He still feels there is a room for change. And a good editor, I would agree there, is what really makes a film. A great shooting sequence can be destroyed if it is not precision. And just like Govind said, you need to know the grammar. You need to be a structured filmmaker to be able to craft and deliver, keep the momentum and rhythm of the film. to be compelling enough for the audiences to be engrossed. Sometimes just a few frames can take away that connect, and you lose, you begin to stray. So I think it's a question that needs a long debate and cross-talk face-to-face. And so script and editing are two different parts. Scripts can be anything, but if in the hand of a good director, they can turn into a beautiful imagery and a story. And in the wrong hands, less experienced perhaps, it can be made a mess of.
I think what, you know, basically Mike is saying is both are complementary to each other. Your story begins with a script and it ends on the editing table.
Okay, great.
So both are equally required.
Govindji, would you describe yourself as more a methodological or a spontaneous director?
A spontaneous director. I think it's a combination of both. You can't be strictly, disciplinarian or strictly intuitional. But the fact is, a combination of both is very important. On-the-spot inspiration, on-the-spot ideas, somebody makes a suggestion, a casual sentence from actor or a technician. One has to be receptive all the time, because once you go on the set, on the film, you are constantly ideating and putting it into practice in front of the camera. So it's a process which is ongoing process. You can't shut yourself and say, no, I'm only methodical actor or director. It's a combination of both.
I think around Twitter, people are more interested in like documentary, because there are not many questions which are coming on the documentary.
Haan, right? Documentary pe bahut sawal aa rahe hain, khas taur par kyunki youth mujhko lagta hai Mike ki ज़्यादा आजकल documentary films की तरफ आकर्षित हैं कि एक सवाल अभी यही आया है कि do you think documentary programs were structured well in Indian institutes than in abroad?
I think they are beginning to improve. There was a time जब ये फिल्में ऐसी थीं कि they were slightly loosely knit together and they were slightly sluggish, but I'm happy to say अभी हम पैनोरामा में हमने कई फिल्में देखी तो वो स्ट्रक्चर्ड भी थीं and they carried the message, content bhi tha, aur achhi filmein ban rahi hain, aur ek badlav aa raha hai, bahut bada badlav aa raha hai, jise dekhkar kafi khushi hui. And hamare filmmakers bhi ab at par with international filmmakers ho gaye hain. To ek achhe documentary maker ki ek sabse badi khasiyat hai ki jitna hi experience ko anubhav ho, wahi ek bahut badi uski buniyad hai, foundation ban jati hai. To har dam, chahe wo ek taxi driver ho, chahe aap khet mein kisan ko milein, चाहे एक मिनिस्टर को मिलें, अगर आप जो भी देखते हैं उसको एंग्रॉस करें और जब ज़रूरत पड़े उसको ट्रांसलेट करें, तो ये एडेड आर्सेनल है आपके लिए, ये इंफॉर्मेशन बैंक है आपका. और एक अच्छे फिल्म मेकर का एक्सपीरियंस जो है, तजुर्बा और एक्सपीरियंस और जो पढ़ता लिखता है वो अगर स्टोर करके रखे, तो वही उसकी काबिलियत में बहुत ही मदद करता.
शंकर जी, एक सवाल आपके लिए है. Were there any good schools for theater arts in India? Since you belong to government as well as the part of film industry, so...
I think there are several such premier schools in India. The National School of Drama in Delhi is the premier school so far as theater is concerned. But you have several independent groups in Delhi, in Bombay. Prithvi Theatres is doing a lot of good work in terms of independent theater. IPTA has done a lot of work in terms of, theater. So there are several groups in all metropolitan cities. I mean, it depends on where this particular person is right now, in which city this person is.
हम कोशिश करेंगे कि सारे सवालों के जवाब दे पाएं. गोविंद जी, एक सवाल आया है. You made very few films, but you are a 6-time national award winner. What is your success sutra?
Well, to say that I must be being kindly watched by somebody on the top. Basically, it is to be true to the subject that you choose. It's very important that you are sincere about it, that you are authentic about it, and you have a certain point of view when you make a film. It is very important that the director has a definite point of view. You may agree with it or you may not agree with it, but he has to have a point of view. And if it is a film which has a certain socially relevant issue or politics or any ideological issue, then I believe that the director must take a stand. Director is not there to offer you solution, but it can always hint at what he would prefer to do in a situation like that. So people can agree with you or not agree with you, that's the risk you take, but you must state your position. That's very important. And the other thing for me is that character is the king. For me, more than the story, the character is very, very important. I am interested in people who put up resistance, who put up fight against injustice or violation of human rights and things like that. And they risk their life. I mean, they may lose or win. That's a different thing. But I believe in the fight, the characters who put up a fight and put their life on the line.
शायद इसीलिए किसी ने पूछा है कि आप आक्रोश का रीमेक दोबारा कब बनाने जा रहे हैं?
इसका?
आक्रोश.
आक्रोश का. आक्रोश से ज़्यादा मुझे वे प्रेशर है कि मैं अर्धसत्य का पार्ट टू बनाऊँ. अर्धसत्य टू. Because आक्रोश का पार्ट टू मुझे इस वक्त समझ में नहीं आ रहा. लेकिन
माइक साहब आपके लिए एक क्वेश्चन है. What technology do you use while shooting a documentary?
Well, I use digital technology, and digital cameras are vogue. And your film tape, film ka format ab kafi. Agar aap kahin bhi dekhen, chahe wo Discovery ho ya BBC ho, all across the world wo almost gayab ho gaya hai. To main digital format mein shoot karta hoon. Aur is waqt hamare paas ek Sony camera hum istemal karte hain. Aur टेपलेस कैमरा एंड आई थिंक वर्सेटाइल और कम दाम में फिल्में बनती हैं. लेकिन उसका एक ज़रूर हम कहेंगे कि पहले हम बहुत गिन के और बहुत रिहर्सल करके एक शॉट लेते थे कि ख़राब ना हो जाए. लेकिन क्योंकि डिजिटल इज़ अवेलेबल एंड इज़ फ्री एंड यू कैन डिलीट, सो 10-10-20-20 शॉट हम ले लेते हैं. तो वो उसमें शायद एक पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू भी, और कभी कभी 20 में से 2-4 शॉट तो ऐसे निकल आते हैं जो कुछ आर्काइव करने योग्य भी हो जाते हैं, और एक आई थिंक लैटिट्यूड भी मिल जाता है.
शंकर जी,
आई थिंक टू जस्ट ऐड टू दैट, यू नो, इफ यू आर वेरी पैशनेट अबाउट स्टार्टिंग योर करियर इन डॉक्यूमेंट्री फिल्म और शॉर्ट फिल्म, इफ यू हैव अ गुड सेल फोन, स्टार्ट यूजिंग इट इमीडिएटली.
ओके,
दैट विल हेल्प यू असेस योर सेल्फ.
टेक्नोलॉजी बहुत बढ़ गई है अभी. आप देखिए 13 MP के जो वो कैमराज वगैरह हैं, बहुत ही अच्छे शार्प हाई डेफिनेशन इमेजेस देती हैं.
आपकी कैनन 8 भी तो अच्छी है.
Sir, one very interesting question is coming. Is it hard to construct a documentary around a subject that won't talk to you?
Yes, I think it's not difficult at all. You see, it's motion picture. If the subject doesn't move, for example, we did a film about a creature that moved only about an inch in 1 hour. So if the subject does not move, the camera moves around. If you look at even when you are interviewing, either you have to interview a person sitting and talking, or the camera moves around or goes in a circle, which adds some motion and interest and hold you, because the perspective keeps changing. So that is very important. That's what crafting is all about. As Govind ji ka, structured training is very important. The grammar of film, what is it? So jab uski buniyad aapke paas hai, to aapke paas kahi bhi bade raaste nikal aate hain. आइडिया इसकी एक अच्छी फिल्म बनाए जो रोचक भी हो, इंटरेस्ट भी होल्ड कर सके, और उसके अंदर वैल्यू भी हो, डेप्थ हो, और आपका कंटेंट तो है ही. डॉक्यूमेंट्रीज में कंटेंट इज किंग. सो हाउ यू डिलीवर इट डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट योर एक्सपीरियंस इज एंड हाउ मच टाइम यू स्पेंड. एक बुनियाद जो होती है डॉक्यूमेंट्रीज की सबसे तगड़ी, वो है रिसर्च. अगर वेल रिसर्च प्रोग्राम हो और उसको आप डिश आउट करें सही तरीके से, तो वो एक बहुत ही रोचक फिल्म बनती है. और अगर लॉप साइडेड हो, अगर बीच में कुछ खामियां हो, तब वो ठिठकना शुरू करती है, गिरना शुरू कर जाती है.
शंकर जी, एक सवाल कई बार आया है. मेनी ऑफ द ट्विटर पीपल हैव आस्क्ड लाइक दिस गोवा हैज बीन मेड अ परमानेंट डेस्टिनेशन फॉर इंटरनेशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल. डू यू रियली सी इंटरनेशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल गोइंग ग्लोबल इन इट्स ब्रांड विद गोवा बीइंग अ डेस्टिनेशन, परमानेंट डेस्टिनेशन?
See, with this year having been declared as a permanent venue, I'm sure, I'm positive, and I'm making this prediction today that the Goa people will invest in infrastructure in a big way. Because this was the only main hurdle that was happening, that the festival was not declared as a permanent festival in Goa. Because you need crores of rupees to make an infrastructure. Why will this government invest in crores of rupees if you don't know that festival is going to be permanent here? So once that hurdle has now been jumped, I'm very positive, you know, with the kind of enthusiasm and keenness with which the Goa government is supporting the festival. They will develop. They already identified the land in Donapola. And it's a matter of time before we have a huge convention center with several theaters and screens happening there. So in the next 5 years, maybe within, you know, before 2016, I'm positive that we will be, you know, looking at a whole new scenario where we have more than, you know, a dozen theaters where we can view these films. It's going to go big, large and
Sir, one corollary from my end, sir, like, do you think infrastructure is, and I think infrastructure is one of the aspects of taking IFFI forward, sir. What other factors which are very much important?
I think the most important thing is to have a market. Yeah. Unless, you know, our filmmakers are able to sell their films to foreign buyers, we are still looking at a festival that is primarily artistic in content. Art and business are two aspects of filmmaking today. Unless you are an independent filmmaker and you are making films to satisfy your own urge, you know, then you don't need to talk about business. But if you are a person who is looking for your audience, you need to know the art of selling your film. So business is equally important as much as making good films. So, you know, the next level is to have a strong market here where we have buyers from abroad here who buy our films and we are able to sell our films abroad. So that platform has not yet happened in Goa for the festival.
Mike, there's one question which says, do you have any plans in directing mainstream cinema or you are happy with the documentaries?
No, I used to be in feature films and I worked in Mumbai in the Indian cinema for on 6-7 films and films like Razia Sultan, Gazab, and Atank was one of the films, and Himalay Putr with Vinod Khanna and all. But I was not very satisfied, and it was not very, for me, very meaningful. So I moved to what was my passion, to documentaries. And I am hoping to, in the next year, I've been working on a script for a long time, and I hope to make a feature film. But before that, I'm doing a docudrama on tigers, which hopefully I will start in, it's a 90-minute film, a feature-length documentary, and it's about real-life experiences. Some of them will be enacted, and this will be starting in January. But it will dovetail into the other film.
Govind ji, ek sawal aapke movie ko leke aa raha hai, about the movie Tamas. We heard that Tamas is close to your heart, and there was one more tweet. Which was asking about what kind of research that you had gone for Tamas movie.
Tamas is really very close to my heart because my family migrated from Karachi to this place, and my early memories of blood, of fear, of panic comes from that period. So and once I decided that I was going to be into films, I decided that one day I'm definitely going to make a film on this. And then I came across Bishan Prani's novel, Tamas, and I decided this was it. Okay. That's happened. But as far as the research is concerned, mostly pictorial, black and white pictures of that period, we had a look at it. And then I took a trip to Punjab. And there, two of my friends helped me very much. Dr. B.N. Goswami, who is an art historian and everything, and Neelam Mansingh Chaudhary, the theatre person. And they, and then we took the trip down several towns of Ludhiana and a couple of other places, where we collected photographs of the architecture, houses, streets. And they became the basis of the sets that we constructed, because whatever you see in Tamas is constructed. Because we couldn't shoot in Punjab because of various reasons. We had no budget to start with, and then with the crowds you can't shoot it. So we decided to shoot everything in Bombay Film City and other practical locations bungalows and things. So everything was shot in Bombay. So, and that's the result of a lot of research we did, pictorial research mostly. And but the other things, I just looked at the book and I thought that novel was excellent. It provided everything.
Rahul, I think we are running out of time. I think one question to you.
Question हाँ ले लेते हैं. शंकर मोहन जी, एक सवाल आया है क्योंकि आपका सिनेमा का बहुत एक लंबा तजुर्बा भी रहा है, तो यंग फिल्म मेकर है और शायद वो जानना भी चाह रहे हैं कि where do our young filmmakers lack, आपकी जो जनरेशन है फिल्म मेकिंग की, सबसे उनको किस चीज की ऐसी जरूरत है जहाँ पर उनको लग रहा है?
I think if he is a passionate filmmaker, he lacks in nothing. He just needs to be self-motivated and he needs to start his journey from wherever he is. As I said earlier, if he has a good smartphone, he should start his journey from there. And as Govindji said, when the right time comes, he should go to a school. Not an expensive school, but there are very lot of schools which are cheaper or sponsored by the government in various state governments. And start learning what cinema is. Cinema is a grammar and language, as Mr. Mike Pandey said. Learn it and then pursue his dreams.
I think one of the things that a young filmmaker can do today is to be a little patient and work hard on your research. Empower yourself with knowledge of technology, of the filmmaking technique, and also how the financial structures are working today. Getting the finance, distribution, exhibition. The more knowledge you have, the more easier it will be to negotiate and identify sources which can give you the knowledge, also the funding. So knowledge is the key.
I think one last question to Mike. Mr. Mike, what is the worst challenge you have faced when making the documentary?
Funds. That's
getting money.
Funds is one of the major challenges
getting
in India.
Money.
It's very, very difficult. And the second major challenge and stumbling block is the red tape. When you're especially trying to get permission to shoot in jungles, sometimes it takes 2 years or 3 years, even after having a proven record and a track record. I don't know, there is provision under the constitution, under the law, wildlife law, that if a film is educational, then you are permitted and given a concession and you can go and film. But perception is lacking, especially at the ground level, where people say no. We are allowed to film, for example, in a jungle from sunrise to sunsets. But the man on location said, no, you can go with the tourist and come out with the tourist. Now, if there are hundreds and thousands of tourists diving towards one single tiger, how do you film? The tiger is wary, is alert, is afraid, because there are so many cars surrounding him. So there's a need to re-look at the whole thing, restructure. And filmmakers should be treated at par with scientists and others, researchers, where they are allowed the seclusion so that you can capture wildlife or whatever you're filming in total comfort and peace. And then only can you bring the magic of cinema or life or nature to the people, to the audiences.
I think one of the things, if I may add, is that wherever these permissions are required and the laws are structured, they should involve and consult the filmmakers, particularly the documentary filmmakers, to understand their needs and accordingly structure the laws. Not just make a law and then let the people suffer.
Very good suggestion, sir. I hope our policymakers who are listening to this program will definitely do amend whatever laws are required, which will facilitate the filmmaking. And with this, we end today's edition of the program, and we'll come again tomorrow with the same time with big two new personalities. And keep tweeting with the hashtag IFFI2014.
Santosh, ye batana bahut zaruri hai ki कल एक ट्वीट हमें को बाद में मिला था, जिसने बड़ी वो नाराज हो गया था कि मैंने ट्वीट किया लेकिन मुझे अपने सवाल का जवाब नहीं मिल पाया, क्योंकि समय का अभाव रहता है, हम ज्यादा ट्वीट कोशिश करते हैं कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा ट्वीट्स के सवालों के जवाब लें, लेकिन आप अपना ट्वीट दोबारा करो, हम कल इस वक्त इस समय दोबारा एक डायरेक्टर एक प्रोड्यूसर के साथ फिर मिलेंगे। हमारी कोशिश है कि एक वर्चुअल वर्ल्ड को एक फिजिकल वर्ल्ड से न्यू मीडिया विंग के माध्यम से आप तक पहुंचे।
थैंक यू।